why I did this research. Birds have been historically used as environmental indicators. Who's familiar with the example of canaries used in mines? Anyone? Well, if you're not, canaries were used in mines to alert miners if there were toxic gases in the environment. Birds naturally migrate to favorable environments, and birds are easy to follow and observe. There are many historical databases, along with a wide following of bird watches. Birds are now making a polar shift towards habitats with cooler environments, where they're shifting altitude to higher environments to achieve these cooler temperatures. The change in density range of birds in the northern hemisphere is increasing in northern boundaries and decreasing in southern boundaries. The opposite is occurring in the southern hemisphere. Mechanisms of range change include a shift in temperature due to microclimate, and also a shift due to food availability for birds, which is either fruit or insects.
Thank you. insects and fruits. We've heard that food availability would differ between the two habitats, thus affecting the birds' found away. We hypothesized there would be more insects in the cool environment and more fruit in the hot environment. And therefore, we see that there's more insectivores in the cool habitat and more fruit lovers in the hot habitat. Birds in transition are often really hard for us to identify, so we only use the birds that we could to clearly identify and save here. Yolanda helped us a lot with the identifying the birds along with the textbook she gave us. The majority of the identified birds in the hot habitat consume both insects and fruit, as you can see there again. And the birds in the cool habitat prefer most of the insects and a combination of both insects. Figures 4 and 5 compare the number of species in the hot cool habitat that were either in transition or non-transition. Transition birds were those that flew right through the environment, and the non-transition birds were the ones that were found to be perched or foraging. To calculate this data, the number of birds in transition and non-transition were divided by the total number of birds that we saw in that habitat pool. As you can see, the hot habitat contained more birds that were in transition, and the cool habitat contained more birds that were not in transition. We also had a very small amount of data for this investigation, so we did not conduct a statistical analysis.
Visibility was difficult for the cool habitat, especially because of the
We also hypothesized that there would be more excess in the cool environment and more birds that ate fruit in the hot, but we were unable to test this. Therefore, in another experiment, we would like to quantify the food sources to see how they affect the bird density and activity. Also, another experiment that we could conduct would be to tag and follow a specific species of birds and observe their habitat preferences. To achieve these results, we catch the birds in a net, tag them, and then release them back into the environment. Here we actually have a picture of a boat creeper that we caught in our net, and then we were able to observe. The nets are about 20 feet in length,